Hi! In this tutorial, we will implement the material effect of snow on the floor. First of all, create a material in the Content Browser tab. Double-click to open Material Editor. Next, create two texture samples for normal and base color. Next, we create a TextCord node that can determine the number of texture UVs, and use the Multiply node to express the number of repetitions of the texture's width and height. After setting the cobble petal base color and normal texture provided by Start Content to the texture sample created earlier, connect the UV values. And then, creating a Multiply node, connect the red channel of the texture to get only the black and white information of the texture, and adjust the value of the red channel by dividing the snow amount value from the constant value. Next, create two 1-minus nodes, one of which is the value of the red channel and the second of the value of the red channel, which is adjusted through the snow amount value. This way, you can get the result of subtracting those values from 1. And if you add these two results through the add node, you can get the black and white values of the material with more pronounced contrast. Then, use the clamp node to limit the given value from going between 1 and 0. Next, using the lerp node, give A the existing base color and B a constant value of 1, which is for white color to express snow, and mix it as much as the alpha ratio of the black and white values created earlier. And the result is connected to the base color. You can see that the white color values are filled between the materials. Next, as more snow accumulates, let's implement the effect that the existing normal value disappears gradually and is replaced by another normal value. Let's use the water normal provided by Start Content to add a normal to replace when more snow is accumulated. And after creating a constant parameter, set the name as normal lerp. Now, connect it to Lerp and adjust the perimeter value so that normal can be converted naturally when more and more snow is piled. In order to do this, we will create an if node and set the value of b to 2.2 to create a condition when snow is completely covered through the value of snow amount, so that normal can be switched spontaneously. Finally, connect it to normal and the material is completed. So, if you adjust the snow amount, you can see that the white color values are filled between the materials, making it look like the snow is filling. Let's save this material and control the material on the level. To do this, open the level blueprint and load the floor reference installed in the level. And we will make this a dynamic material instance so that it can be changed during gameplay without recompilation. Lastly, we will use the first timeline to change the snow amount value of the material based on time. And when the event ends, we will naturally change the normal value to create a simple animation that makes the snow more piled up. Thank you. Now, go to the content browser and run it, and you can see the floor material fill up with snow. After this, when more snow is accumulated, you can see that normal is also switched naturally. In the next video, we're going to learn how to make snow particles. And let's end this tutorial.